Hey there, so I wanted to share with you some gluten-free options at Universal Studios Orlando. We stayed there for 2 days and found some gluten-free options in the parks, in City Walk, and around Universal Studios. First off, if you would like to eat at any restaurant in particular, I would definitely make a reservation. There was a few restaurants we really wanted to try inside the parks and weren't able to because if you didn't have a reservation, you couldn't even go in and they would be booked up for a few days out. There were still some quick walk-up options, but even restaurants I didn't think you'd need a reservation to, you did. At the Universal Studios Park, we only ate at one restaurant. It was for breakfast, the Today Cafe. It's right at the entrance of Universal Studios, and it looks like it has a couple of gluten-free options for lunchtime, but for breakfast, I was only able to find one option that looked like it was truly gluten-free, which is the acai bowl, and I opted to have the granola off of it. The staff there was really friendly and helpful, and I feel like they would be accommodating to find some good options for lunchtime. Here's the acai bowl. It was cold, fruity, and had some toasted coconut on top. I like to eat these type of bowls, so I would definitely go back and get that again. Moving on to Islands of Adventure, which is my favorite park. Unfortunately, there's not a ton of gluten-free options in this park either, but you can find a few. Like this Confisco Grill, which is towards the beginning of the park. The only gluten-free option on their menu was the fish of the day, so we didn't try to eat there. But then they have the stands right outside where you can find the coveted turkey legs, which the worker was pretty sure was gluten-free, but you may want to double check that. The Mythos restaurant had really good reviews and we couldn't get in because it was very booked up with reservations as well. But it looks like on the gluten-free menu, they have like two or three options. I don't know if it would be worth it for me to eat there, but I have heard their staff is really good at accommodating for those with allergies. So that's great. In the Harry Potter areas, there are two restaurants that we particularly wanted to eat at, which was the Three Broomsticks and the Leaky Cauldron. Once again, we didn't get in because of the reservation issue, but I did hear at, I think, the Three Broomsticks, they had gluten-free pancakes. And they have some other meat and vegetable and potato options that are gluten-free as well. So I would definitely recommend giving those a shot. And the butter beer I hear is gluten-free. Unfortunately, I didn't get to try it because I have a corn allergy and butter beer has corn syrup. Dang it, looks really delicious. Long, long line for the butter beer. So if you want to get the butter beer, I'd get there early or be willing to wait in the line. Found the best gluten-free options in City Walk, which, if you don't know, shopping eating area right outside the park. Cowfish was the only restaurant we could find that day without crazy reservations, and actually they didn't have too bad of a selection of some gluten-free options. As you can see here on the menu, the things marked in yellow are gluten-free, and they also offered a gluten-free bun. These Parmesan truffle fries were so good. I would totally eat these again. I loved them. My husband loved them. They were a great appetizer to start off with. And I ended up getting a burger. I think it was the black and blue or black and brie, but it was actually pretty good. You know, the bun was tasted like a gluten-free bun, but it was definitely nice that that was an option. And the French fries were fried in a separate fryer, so didn't have to worry about cross-contamination with those. The one place we did make a reservation to was Margaritaville, where it's 5 o'clock somewhere. Actually, their gluten-free menu was really good, and the chef came out personally to talk to me about how he could modify any of the food to meet my dietary restrictions, which was super nice. The restaurant's kind of relaxing, casual, and fun. Just a good place to eat. I would definitely go there again. I ordered the Cobb salad for my meal, and it was delicious. And my husband ordered the chicken fried steak, which is not gluten-free. However, it might be a good option for somebody that you are traveling with. Some other places in City Walk that have gluten-free options but that we did not eat at was the Hotdog place. They actually have a gluten-free bun that they offer, but they didn't have it that day, but I would imagine you could eat most of the hot dogs in the gluten-free bun. Antojitos had a lot of gluten-free options on their menu and looked pretty tasty. So if you like Mexican, I would definitely give that a go. And then there's also Bob Marley's, which has a Jamaican type vibe going for it. The menu selection looked pretty promising. And if I were to choose something, I would go with the jerk chicken option. The menu sides are all gluten-free. One more place that looks so cool on the outside is the Chocolate Emporium. They actually have a lot of desserts, some milkshakes that look amazing, but not very many that are gluten-free. I think there might be one gluten-free milkshake option, and unfortunately it didn't seem like they had it available that day, so that might be something you might want to look into further. Sadly, I was fooled by these macarons because I figured almond flour might be gluten-free, and the lady assured me that they are not gluten-free. But they said they do have a couple of chocolates in the shop that you might be able to find on the shelves that are gluten-free. Not really worth it to me. I would recommend trying out the restaurant if you want to try. They had like an appetizer, maybe a couple entrees that were gluten-free. But other than that, Chocolate Emporium, you're just pretty to look at, but not good to eat at. Now moving outside of the Universal area, we were able to eat at two restaurants, which I highly recommend. One was for dinner, one was for breakfast. The first one was Cooper Hawks, which is actually known for their winery. We don't drink, but their gluten-free menu was outstanding on options. They had two pages of gluten-free, and we were able to get a gluten-free bread that they brought to the table for me, which actually was pretty good. As far as gluten-free bread goes, I loved it. And we also got an appetizer, which was like a bacon-wrapped shrimp with a delicious like butter sauce and guacamole. I would totally eat that again as well. My husband and I split a gluten-free entree, which they separated onto two plates, which was plenty for both of us after having those other two things. And it was like a Parmesan crusted gluten-free chicken. So good. Lastly, we had a gluten-free creme brulee, which was a salted caramel. I actually prefer vanilla bean creme brulee, but still not bad. Lastly, for breakfast, we ate at First Watch, which is a restaurant you can find in a few different states, but this one is actually right outside of Universal Orlando. They have a great menu. I've actually eaten here a few times, and my favorite is the pesto chicken quinoa bowl, which is so good. I want to try to recreate this dish at home myself. They also have quite a few delicious other options, so check it out. Here's my pesto quinoa bowl. Love the blend of flavors, the lemon, the pesto, the tomato, and it's pretty healthy too, which is a bonus. The staff there seems really accommodating, and although my husband's breakfast is not gluten-free, the chikichanga, it seems like they can make dishes to fit your allergy needs. So that is it. That was my gluten-free experience for Universal Studios Orlando for the 2 days that we were able to go. And I thought overall there are some options that you can get in and around the park. I would definitely remember, make reservations. It'll make for a much better experience so you're not scrambling to find somewhere to eat. Anyway, hope this video was helpful and enjoy your trip to Universal Studios. Bye!